Do you have an idea that you would like added to Minecraft? Well, you've come to just the right place. Most of the time, I make videos about my ideas, but this series is all about you. That being said, my name is SystemZ, and today I'm bringing your crazy and out-of-this-world ideas into Minecraft. Comment down below what you would like added, and maybe I'll choose it for the next episode. If you enjoyed the video and want to support my channel and help me make videos in the future, consider becoming a member, where you'll be invited to my Minecraft and Discord servers, as well as have a chance to help me with new videos through exclusive community posts. Click the join button below for more information, and also thank you to those of you who have become a member since my last video. Welcome back, everybody, to a brand new video. My name, of course, is SystemZ, and today we are in the caverns below looking for the good stuff, the valuables. You know what I'm talking about. The fossils. Definitely not the diamonds. The fossils is what we are looking for, because that is idea number one in a collection of your ideas in Minecraft. Welcome to episode 8. I know, we've been doing these a lot lately, but you guys seem to really enjoy them. So, without further ado, let's jump right on into it. I know, that was bad. I'm sorry. Fossils are the first idea. This is a new block that would essentially spawn underground. It doesn't really matter where you're at in terms of a biome. It's simply underground, and it could be embedded in dirt, stone, sand, and all sorts of other earthy type materials. Fossils would be a new material that, when mined using a shovel or a pickaxe, depending on what the main block is made up of, it would drop various different items. Now, I've got my friend Anchor here, who I picked off of a local pirate ship. He was kind of up to no good, but he's turned his life around, helping me with some archaeology, as you can see here, and that's where we've discovered bones, nautilus shells, and after like a billion different blocks, we got a diamond. And that's because diamonds would be an absolutely, I can't say that enough, rare drop. This would definitely not be common, but you could see the different items that might come from these various different blocks. Now, I like to believe that depending on what the host block is, like stone for example, it would change the different drops, as opposed to having the same no matter what fossil block it comes from. Now, aside from the really cool mechanics that could come from a fossil block, I think it looks great as a building block. Imagine having something like this for building pathways. I think that could be incredibly cool, not to mention having the various different types with the stone and the sand. I think it really provides a cool aesthetic to have variation like this, so I think it is awesome. Plus, we could have different colors of fossils depending on the block. So, for example, for building in stone, it may look more like rocks that are embedded. I think that would be very cool. I think there's a lot of different ways we could implement fossils into the game. Anchor seems to really enjoy this particular version. But of course, let me know what you think of this, as well as all of the other little ideas as far as the drops go, in the comments down below. My friends, you know just as well as I do that when it's nighttime, it's about to go down. And that's exactly what's about to happen, because we have found ourselves the next idea, which is the new Necromancer. Part of the Illager army, this guy would spawn during raids that occur at night. And I've got to say, it is incredibly spooky. So, of course, just like the previous idea, let's jump right into it. I'm sorry, that's so bad. As you can see, we've got skeletons, we've got zombies, the Necromancer. Oh my, there's a lot of different stuff going on here. So let's jump right on into it again. I don't know why I'm repeating myself at this point. The Necromancer would essentially be a new Illager that would control the dead. It would spawn different mobs like you see here and have them attack you, all through the power of this amulet, which when killed, it would actually have a chance at dropping the Charm of the Dead, or Charm of Dead for short, which, as you can see, if we go ahead and throw on, it looks pretty fancy. I've got to say, it's a new piece of jewelry that you can rock and look like the coolest Minecrafter out there. But what does it do, SystemZ? That's a great question. Random commenter number 9. So, I don't know what's 9, but the Charm of the Dead would essentially allow you to have the chance at controlling nearby skeletons or zombies. It would be very rare, but essentially if you have 10 different zombies after you, or 10 different skeletons, one of them may spawn around the corner and start attacking those mobs for you, disappearing once they've completed the job. I think that is a really interesting idea. It sounds a little bit more modded than I would like to admit. I know vanilla Minecraft is kind of the goal with a lot of these videos, but honestly, I think it could find its way in the game. It kind of fits in the Totem of Undying class, which I think is very cool. So, of course, let me know what you think of this down in the comments below. And look, we're matching. We're super fancy. The dude loves it. How you doing, bud? Oh my god, how you doing, brother? So close. Okay, well, that's essentially it for this idea. Let me know what you think of that down in the comments below. Speaking of magical items, let's go ahead and check out idea number 3, which honestly was not originally going to make it in this video. It wasn't until Energized and I kind of talked about exactly what this idea could mean and how interesting it could be for the game. That being said, let's go ahead and check this out. So as you can see, we've got a parrot here in front of me. Now what exactly is this parrot here for other than to look fantastic? And why in the world is there a Totem of Undying right behind the guy? So the Totem of Undying is a very interesting object. As you know, it's kind of a bit popular at the moment because a lot of people think it would be great to have various different types of totems in the game. But that's not what we're doing today. We're going to take a look at how exactly this Totem of Undying could interact with a parrot of all mobs. Let's say that you don't really want to hold this particular item in your inventory. It can kind of get annoying to have something that takes up inventory space. Not to mention having to have it held, if I'm not mistaken. So, I think it would be really cool if you could toss it onto a parrot, which is very interesting, I know, it's a little weird, and it develops this phoenix that allows you to essentially have the power of a Totem of Undying without actually keeping the totem in your inventory. Now, this particular mob would fly around above you. As you can see here, we've got an example of this particular phoenix. It would fly around no matter where you went in the game. It could even phase through blocks if it needed to. And whenever you die, it swoops down and resurrects you, and then, of course, turns into your parrot, spawning once again on your shoulder as it previously was. Now, like I said, this was not originally going to make it in the video because, let's be honest, this is a wild idea. But honestly, it's super cool and it makes sense because it allows us to not have to have the Totem of Undying in our inventory. Now, what I really like about this phoenix is that you can tell it's pretty much an exact replica of the Totem of Undying, except in bird form. But still, I think it's really good. And honestly, Energized, you have done a fantastic idea with this model and texture, my friend. So thank you again for helping me with this and all of the other stuff in the videos. But of course, let me know what you think of this down in the comments below. Does this deserve a place in Minecraft? It's very different, but very, very cool. Last but certainly not least, we've got probably one of the weirdest ideas of all, but honestly, this one would be incredibly awesome and actually add a really interesting mechanic to villages as we currently know them. So as you can see, we've got two different types of iron golems here in front of us. Iron golems are made entirely out of iron, and with iron, swords, weapons, pickaxes, tools, of course, armor, basically anything that is iron, you are currently able to enchant. So wouldn't it make sense that you could also enchant an iron golem, simply by right-clicking it with the enchanted book? Now this one, as an example, has fire aspect, so you can imagine what that means is essentially whenever it hits a mob, it sets them on fire. Which honestly just sounds super awesome alone. But you could also provide unbreaking so that it has a little bit more defense and doesn't break as easily, which I think fits perfectly with the new animations of them slowly breaking, as well as blast protection against creepers. I think there's all sorts of ways to implement enchants to the particular golems, whether using the currently existing enchantments or even an entirely new set of enchantments altogether. I think this is awesome, because having different souped up golems like this could mean more protection for villages and honestly just any build. It would allow them to protect better against different mobs, especially during raids. So I think this could be really cool, especially for in-game type content. Being able to bonus up the defense of a village would be super, super cool. And honestly, I think this is a great way to do it. Plus, like I said, it just makes sense. If you're able to enchant essentially anything using iron, why not be able to do it with golems as well? Not to mention, they just look super cool with their different effects. As you can see, the visuals change depending on what enchantment you have, as well as particles. I think this is awesome. But I'd like to know, let me know what kind of enchantments you think could be added to the game that would be golem specific, because I think that's really where the magic of this idea comes in. But of course, let me know what you think of this, as well as all of the other ideas featured in this video down in the comments below. Which one would you like to see the most? If you could only pick one, let me know what your favorite is. And as always, I'll see you for the next ideas in Minecraft. But let's go ahead and roll the outro. That's gonna be it for today's video. If you enjoyed, make sure to leave a thumbs up and consider subscribing and turning on notifications so that you never miss an upload. And like I said, that's gonna be it for today. My name has been System Z. You guys have been awesome, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.